What's good, my friend? Welcome to another video. If we haven't met yet, my name is Ted and I talk bass. I make bass tutorials for people who want to understand the bass a little bit better, get a little bit better at bass. One of the ways that I think is the best way to do that, is by learning real songs. And I'm in this season of digging into crates, finding tunes that I, you know, have influenced me, players that have influenced me, and kind of, you know, trying to reignite it for me. And I want to share that with you. So in this video, I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to play a lot, so I will not be able to monetize this. I may potentially get a copyright strike, definitely a copyright claim, but this tune is kind of hard to explain without some context. A lot of them are, but I'm going to be playing through that. Anyway, having said all that, do me a favor. If you find value in the video, you can show your appreciation in a few different ways. You can hit that subscribe button. You could like the video. You could buy me a cup of coffee by sending me a tip through one of the links below. All right, so this tune is called First Class Love. It's by Tina Marie. It's got Alan McGreer on bass. Yeah, let's dig into it. I'm gonna play like the A section for you first. Okay, so now I'm gonna play it in the way that I interpret it, but as always, especially with this old school funk stuff, it's important to get the ingredients, right? The ingredients be the same and are similar in a lot of these funk tunes. So we got, there's a pattern. Hammer on from D to E, then a thump on E. That's the first part of it. What I'm doing there is a dead pluck. So let me try to do it real slow. I added another dead pluck in there. I don't think Alan plays it exactly like that. That's what I'm doing. Okay, so that time I did a dead thump. You see what I'm saying? So, and I compensated with the dead pluck because, quite honestly, I don't have that the extra thump in there clean like I wanted. So I play it like, that's the second half of it. You hear that? You see here and see this all the time. That is that pluck D, hammer on to E on the G string. So that's yeah, it's hard to slow it down and like really like explain it, but there's a palm slap on the left hand, so. Best way that I could tell you to get that under your fingers. Sorry. I'm kind of grabbing that D with sort of the meat of my fingers. This video is going to be maybe a little bit long. And I'm going to try to shorten it down. So take that part. I know that's a lot of information right there. Rewind that or loop that part. Now on YouTube, you can slow it down and stuff like that. So try that out as well. Let's go to sort of the B section, okay? I'm going to say there's a B section and there's a B prime. I don't really want to call it a C section yet. I'm not comfortable with that yet.
Comes right here. G.
Okay, so all we're doing is right back to the two, three. I should tune. You see what I'm saying? Really easy to fit that ear. One and two. Now I'm going to say this is B prime, right? And you'll see why in a second when why I'm saying that and not calling it C, because there's another big part, and this is a part. We'll get to it. Computer is kind of tripping, that's why you get that skip. So A, D flat, G flat. These songs be like some of the, you really want to learn how to thump, it ain't in no book, it ain't in no, it's not even in this YouTube video, it's in sitting down with the music, turning off all the other stuff. And sitting down with the music. Okay, so now let's go to this part, which is just so cool. Oh, it's coming now. What you want to do with something like this is it's like a paradiddle, right? Like drummers do a little paradiddle. So just strike in the open E. I really don't play that D, excuse me, until, you know, it's really like ghost notes right there. So I thumb that open E. Now my thumb is muting the D string, the E string. And these three fingers are muting the other strings, but kind of easing up off the pressure for the D. C sharp, D, and then there's the D to E, common, right? You know that metronome challenge that's on like TikTok, Instagram, and all those places that like Victor Wooten came up with in the Groove Workshop? Try something like that with something like this. You know what I mean? Hammer on, C sharp to D with my first and second finger. And then same thing. then the turnaround, he does, not the turnaround, but the little fill he does it consistently. I kind of cheat on it and go, but so like my suggestion is kind of twofold. One, just like all my other videos, when I say get inside, you know, just use this as a reference, but then go listen to the record. Listen to the record and try to get inside the record. Use this as a reference. Get inside the record. And then just sit with the paradiddle. Right now, I'm not playing no notes. Then you can throw those hammer-ons, like, you know, you can move those hammer-ons to any note you want in that E minor vibe. Workout. First Class Love, Tina Marie. It's kind of a cut joint from, I think it's Irons in the Fire is the name of the record. But yeah, man, try it on for size. Have a little fun with it. I appreciate you spending your time here with me today. You could be anywhere. You could be anywhere on anybody's channel doing anything you want. You're here with me. I appreciate it. So yeah, until next time. Peace. Two fingers.